Hello everybody and welcome to Usitility. Well, we're on the way to discover how to run Frost and Flame King of Avalon on your PC. As you can see, you are able to display it on your screen. It will be possible to easily download and set up Frost and Flame King of Avalon so that we can enjoy playing your game on our Windows desktop or laptop with keyboard, mouse and large monitor. So it's time to have fun, let's go buddies! First of all buddies, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite internet browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to that URL that I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, because I added the clickable link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed there on our own website of Usitility, exactly where we find here a precise information on the way to obtain Frost and Flame King of Avalon on laptop or computer. We scroll lower a tad and mouse click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on this link, we get to the website of LDPlayer. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we are going to run to get access to that game Frost and Flame King of Avalon on our PC. As you can discover here, we access some pros of preferring using this emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and so on. Now we are ready to proceed to download the Frost and Flame King of Avalon by clicking on this button, Download Frost and Flame King of Avalon on PC, that you can see here in green color. We then click on it. And the download step starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to launch the installer, okay, then we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the computer. We have clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to see the installer considerably better. The installer is really straightforward. It consists of two possibilities, install and setup path. I will show you what setup path does indeed. We simply click on it. And we note that we've got here the path where in fact the emulator will be set up. If we choose to change for better this folder, we have got to click on that browse option and we select another folder and set up the emulator precisely where we want. To keep it simple, just set it where it is. I simply click back, and I simply click install. Now, prior to starting setting up this emulator, it is possible that it will suggest us several application deals to put on our laptop. Since I do not want to have any of those software program, I only click each time on the reject option. Now, there it is. The setup commences and it is going to proceed together with the download of all these MB which are represented on our computer screen. When you download it, it might possibly be a bit more or less MB. The data transfer rate may go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, based on your type of access to the web and depending on the velocity of the emulator web servers. Right away they're running superbly fast. The download has been completed, then now it proceeds with the setup part. The setup will need a little bit more or less time, primarily based on the power of your machine. The more efficient it really is, the faster the software setup time and or vice versa. If we combine the download and software setup stage, it will take a very long time, so show patience. It has now finished for me. Now, the emulator happens to be launched instantly. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will advance to the right, and once it actually reaches the finish, the emulator can be started for the first time. In fact, the emulator has been launched, here it is for the very first time. And LD Store is instantly launched, which is a sort of Google Play. It's not the best technique to set up the video game, and I don't advise using it, basically because usually the LD Store sets up an out-of-date version of the game. Allow me to let you know tips on how to set up the video game though using Google Play, so I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we have to begin doing is to go to the desktop by pressing this software icon that I'm indicating in green color. Before we continue, as now you can see, it has created two app icons right here on the computer desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player software icon will be only one we're interested in. When we have to launch Frost and Flame King of Avalon on the desktop or laptop, we double mouse click on that app icon and consequently start the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon isn't about multiplayer or even anything at all like this. The truth is, it's an icon that we may most certainly never ever work with. Let's conduct the next phase, which is a must, and which is to log on to the Google Play Store. To do this, we will browse here to System Apps, we click. And we will just click on Play Store. As you can see, the Google Play is started. In this case, we are required to sign in. Now once we are there, we must absolutely begin doing this following step that is imperative. So we simply click on Sign In. Now it shows checking info. It can from time to time get stopped at checking info, and so it fails to progress. If so, you may try to log in after a number of hours, but it will surely usually be resolved. Now we're going to type our username and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. For instance, you can utilize the same email you are using at this moment in your own YouTube account. So that I will enter my details and I'll return when I have done it. That's it, info entered. This is Google welcoming us and supplying us their twos. We should consent to them simply by pressing I agree. Next, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You could keep it selected and this will build a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you can use that option if you prefer. We just click on accept. The Google Play is started as favorite choice and automatically. However, if the Google Play just isn't started instantly and you have no clue how to start it by yourself, I show you how to do it now. The very first thing is to navigate to the emulator desktop by clicking this app icon marked in green color. Now we head to the system apps folder. And we click on the Play Store icon. Okay, we are here within Google Play. What we intend to accomplish will be browse here to search for apps and games. And consequently we're going to research Frost and Flame King of Avalon. Furthermore, there we have it, we are going to choose the very first result. Here we have got the game. Why don't we just click right here on the install choice that I am just presenting now in green color. And it will commence the installation. At present it would download on your desktop or laptop and set up the Android game, it can take a while or it might well be amazingly quickly. It again all will depend on our own internet access. This has just ended setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by pressing the following button that I am showing in green, that allows you to start Frost and Flame King of Avalon for the first time. We are by then on the emulator desktop, and we're about to click that brand new Frost and Flame King of Avalon app icon that was provided. The game app is launched for the first time. Here we get it, I can also press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the sound level of that emulator. It is here. We use the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we could activate the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This is actually the very first one, we mouse click on this app icon which I am identifying in green color. And the monitor is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. If we need to run the game in full screen, we select this particular application icon. And we might without a doubt be experiencing and enjoying the game in full screen function. To get out of the 100% screen setting, hit the F11 key. And we might currently play in normal computer screen setting. Now I am choosing to demonstrate you the keyboard mapping which is certainly quite enjoyable. That step we definitely will be ready to use the video game a lot more effortlessly. The very first thing is to press this software icon. It's now time to complete the necessary adjustments. I can let the standard settings, though if you need to change this, you can also do this without having problem. I take this occasion to comment that from time to time, when launching the game app a dark screen comes out, if it's like that and you see the black screen and that emulator fails to initiate, I propose a feasible technique. We would click here, to the cogwheel. In the emulator preferences, in the advanced selection we have various resolutions. That is the pixel quality we have at this time opted for as favorite choice and we must choose any of these other screen resolutions, for instance that one here. We select it and then press save. It will probably require us to reboot that emulator and right after rebooted, most probably the emulator will start up and this black display screen will vanish entirely. Clearly, the emulator is entirely in our language. From time to time it occurs that your emulator is started in the erroneous language, such as, in Chinese. And to place it in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. And there throughout other configurations, we click the language drop down. We can easily go with the language we prefer, German, Mandarin, and so on. Once the language is selected, we could save, the emulator will reboot, and the game application, next time we start it, would of course be in the chosen language. Now, you can find another thing that we must take into account, and this is that we will get an email telling that a completely new electronic device has been connected to this Google account. It should check with us if we're the people who have associated with that device. Yup, we may not be troubled, considering the fact that emulator is behaving like an Google Android electronic device. And to find which device is being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. And we browse here to the model selection. And here we discover that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for my tutorial. I believe you appreciated it, specifically that everyone thought it was informative. If that is so, bring it a good like, subscribe, and any remarks, requests or suggestions, put them in the comment area down below. You can even leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams occasionally, you have it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click any of these instructional videos that happens to be showing up on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the upcoming video tutorials. Bye!